tipped us and none of us thought of checking that.
Somebody's coming back. I'm not sure who, though.
Yeah, that was a internet. Full-on internet went down. I mean, like, you know, the modem went down, too, so.
Wow.
Stupid freaking charter. That's a fratta.
Oh, Whisper Cat has Twitch up, actually, so they are listening in on us. So, yeah, they're fried for a moment.
This happens. Charter, die. Horrible, painful death. Die in a fire. Because it's been 2 weeks, and the modem's been going up and down. And, of course, I can't log in because I'm already logged in. Story of my week.
All right, so...
Yeah, both of you are still sitting here.
All
right. Aaron, do you know...
She was out of nano.
I was out of nano, yes.
Okay, when you get back in the game... Okay. When you get back in the game, delete the buff I gave you. Because I want to give you double buff, but as a single, it's pretty useless.
It's not... Okay, it's not letting me log in right now.
Because
they're both still loaded in. You have to wait until they actually time out.
Alright.
Just give it. Yeah,
looks like Randy got in.
Yeah, it just takes a couple moments. Yeah. Stupid freaking internet. Pain in the.
Fucking.
Yeah, as soon as I heard Aaron cut off at the end of his. Before she was done with a sentence, I'm like, oh, God.
Well, no, I knew it before that because I started to hear her break up, and then you started talking, and you started to break up, and then it went silent, and I'm like, oh, crap. Which is why I sat down on my screen, which you never saw, because I was just like, can I stand up? Nope. Lagged out. Wow. I haven't played with my stats in a while. That's an IP number I don't see until, like, endgame. I have 200,000 IP to play with. What?
Welcome back, Aaron. I can see it in the orbit.
Someone's having a chuckle at your lack of nano in my chat.
Delete the time and space buff I gave you.
Silly moment is silly.
The fun part is that the remaining three of us morons are standing here. It's like, are you getting this buff? You're getting this buff? None of us thought to check the window for nano.
What was the time and space nano? Health?
Yeah, delete it.
I don't know what it looks like.
It's like a
brain. Oh, I see it. Malcolm's gift of space time.
Yeah. Delete that.
Okay. Deleted. I think. Yep. Deleted.
And Zell becomes sparkly glowy.
Yay! I'm all shiny! And I'm less stupid! Oh my god, I can't believe I didn't think of that. Why?
I cannot believe none of us thought of it.
None of us thought of. Wait, what about your mana? What about your nanos? Just
we're just like, wait, what could be wrong? What could be wrong? Oh, it's like the most obvious thing. All right. So sorry about that, everyone. We are
speaking of nano pool. I'm gonna
hang on. I've got actually. Oh, actually, we are still streaming now. it's just not showing up on my. I just all tabbed out. Okay, good. If the game would have crashed at that point, I would have killed someone. I would have just murdered.
I hope it's not me you want to kill.
No. I will go for someone who is easy to reach.
oh, that's bad for me.
I've been a good boy this year. So.
Better watch out, dude. She's lethal with those nunchucks.
Yes, but you're in another country.
I'm
in the room next door.
Fun fact, I have actually hit Matt with nunchucks before.
Yes, and it popped my spine and immediately afterwards went, that just fixed my step back.
Yay. Alright, so we're...
She can
people.
Break a spine as easily as she can help it.
Alright, I'm guessing everyone is not following us, because...
No, because I don't know where you're at.
He said follow me, and I followed him, but apparently
I have no idea. I'm busy trying to keep an eye on it on the
That's not our group. Never mind.
It's not
I have no idea where you guys went.
This way.
Oh, we were about ready to jump down.
Oh,
don't,
that would be
don't
bad.
Fall.
That
fall.
Would be very, very bad. There are hacks down
there,
and they would eat
you. God, I just rubber banded.
Woo!
Yep, so did
don't
I.
Rubber band across the bridge.
That's
well, I was
gotta
about
be,
to jump over a lump, and all of a sudden I'm at the base end of it again. Like,
look at that. Like
remember,
giant floating lily pads.
Remember, this is not nonsense. It's not us forgiven to make mistakes.
Yes.
Yeah, and the thing about these, anytime you see a bridge like this, there is a strong possibility there are hex below it. There is even the possibility they will aggro you even when walking on a bridge.
Are you serious, game? Are you serious right now? Are you trying to crash on me right now? You
oh,
just
God.
Crashed on me. Son
oh,
of a bitch.
Son of a bitch.
Well, he's walking straight. He's managed to cross the bridge.
Yay, get across the bridge,
he's crossed
Kat,
the bridge. He's gotten past the monsters and there's nothing but their
life. He's reloading. About to walk into. He's about to walk into the heck field.
Post
oh,
program.
Shit.
There's nothing I can do to stop. Oh, wait. He just linked that out before walking down the hill.
I forced the program to stop.
Oh, I forgot to send a tweet. The tweet out. Oops. Well, it's a good thing we're going extra long today. Oh, yes. Nice. Good shout out to Solomon, who was watching earlier and actually noticed that I was out of Nano. Thank you very
Sullivan
much.
Was the one that mentioned it in my chat, too.
Okay, so I
check
I
your nano!
Yes. He was, like, crying. He was, like, screaming at me, check my nano! Reheal!
It's kind of nice seeing other people showing up and joining the team. It's,
And
nice.
The other people in our chats shouting at us when we're doing noobish things.
Actually, that particular thing, failing to check your nano, is something that will continue no matter how veteran a character you are. You'll occasionally have the moment of, duh.
Well,
oh,
also,
crap!
Also,
crap. I just got Heckler Ag from someplace. I do not know where.
Okay, stay with me.
It's down below us, I think.
It's
coming up the side.
I just saw the red attacked by Heckler of Stones.
Here he comes. Walking down the street. Oh, he's caught on the corner.
He can't get to you. Don't worry,
he's
right?
Talking.
Oh, now he wants to give a piece of me.
I actually know right where
we
are.
Oh, here he is!
Woo!
Yep. Yep, I when I see that red, when I'm up here and I see that red attacked by Heckler of Stones.
Okay, this is nice. The enforcer is aware this happened and decided to kill it. So nothing happened to us.
Did too little damage.
That's fine. Actually, I got a little bit of XP
from
that.
Wait, was he the enforcer from
before?
Oh, wait. You were not in team.
No.
Yeah, I wasn't in team, that's why.
Yeah, that's not the same enforcer. Remember to follow, guys.
Yep,
that's good when an enforcer knows that keep tabs on that. I occasionally have that happen even when I'm out here by myself. Crossing these bridges, these hecklers can be really hyper aggro.
Yeah, they can.
They have a huge aggro range, and if you look very carefully, we are crossing a bridge with them below us, so...
Ah, and the enforcer is, like, following along underneath.
Nah, he's not following us. He's taking the...
Oh, he's taking them. Okay.
He's pocketing for a team. Okay.
It just so happens that there's a heckler and bothering another team, and he decided to intervene.
Yep.
It's nice,
so nice
that he took the hack. He was worried about us dying, so instead of, he decided to kill it.
Worry about me dying.
Well,
that
you
was
very
twice
you
today.
Very nearly Link died there. That was, I mean, you did go Link dead, but you very nearly died while Link dead.
Hey, I have.
Because I'm watching you nearly walking off into that pit, and I'm going, oh crap. Boop. Oh dear God! And then as
you're announcing every step my character is taking, it's like. Close the program, tunk. Closed it.
Things you can only learn to do while actually on a call with somebody on your team.
Pull the plug.
It's amazing how digital progress has actually given us the ability to know that. Yes, Matt, you went LinkedIn, you're still running, and you're about to die.
Program has shut down.
I actually finally
You just
equipped...
stopped and you sat down. He is not dying today again today.
I did finally just equip neuronal stimulator, by the way. I forgot that I had that. It was sitting around in my survivalist backpack. That's why I didn't know.
If you are a nano profession, i.e., any pet profession, nanotechnician, doctor, any of the above, having that 23 points of int bleed down into your nano skills is a good thing.
Yeah.
Jump in there.
We're getting Arcarash coming into the party here. I don't know where it came from, but it wants me dead.
It's not a high level. So.
I know it's not a high level. It's just, remember, I'm a doc. I'm using a chalice. I have no way of fighting back.
Remember, when I'm pulling, don't walk close to me.
Okay, gotcha. Everybody stand back.
Back.
Just
back,
make
back.
Sure you don't go too far back that you find more things.
That's
actually
why
about where Matt
me.
Is good. And my whole job is to sit here, keep an eye on Krister's health, and make sure he doesn't die. Although the metaphysicist pets are doing an excellent job of that as it is.
I'm actually worried about
That's a 96 Whisper Cat's a 96 shade. Definitely,
yeah, I'm actually
shades need the love, so.
What were you saying, Krister?
Yeah, I'm actually a little bit bored sometimes. He can get ag at the early packs because he can backstab and such. And backstab can it's more like RNG damage, so it can do like 10k and stuff.
Okay, so I'm actually going to keep an eye on the Shade's health and half an eye on Matt's. He does have his own auras.
And my auras are up and working now.
And Trox's health.
If I get the aim shot on, it's all fine, because I've already been able to pump up the damage, but I can't sneak for the hecklers, so I need to use the other way to aim a shot, basically.
Now, I know, it's less now, but it used to be shades were about 180 levels of suck followed by 40 levels of awesome. And, yep, Whisper Cat says no backstab there, so. You should get all the egg. I remember when I was doing Ellie Sank Quest on my main, a Shade asked to go along because even at 90, they were having trouble doing the Sank Quest by themselves. And so I let them come along and I just ate everything.
Actually, I don't think he can take egg because I have enough taunts already. I didn't think about how much taunt my buff gives. It's already 10k, so it's pretty good.
Yeah. Sheet of perennium.
You take it if you want. They're good for making perennium guns.
Ooh,
okay,
hey, good
for making stuff later.
Did you load in properly this time?
That is a very good piece of perennium sheet, by the way, Matt. That is a 199 sheet of perennium. That's actually
yeah, that can be 200.
It's a good sheet.
You can make a 200 gun with that.
And down.
Whew, almost level 80.
And you, they fall, the entire ground shakes. I've always loved that.
Heckler of Metals.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's different names for them.
Yeah, there's like Heckler of Earth or something?
There's another one, Heckler of Earth, Heckler of Stones, Heckler of Metals. There's a couple of other unique Hecklers names that you see like, later on.
Yeah, like Heckler of Dreams and stuff.
Yeah.
Actually, and, that's not a unique. That's just a simple Ado Heckler, basically.
No, but I mean, it's a different name than what you normally see, but it's, I think, isn't that an Ado?
Yeah, it's a simple Ado Heckler. You have then, Harmony, and you have Dreams, and then you have, oh my god, I'm... my brain is weak. The Force is not with me.
Speaking of the Force...
Oh, yeah.
Finally got to see Rogue One yesterday.
Spoiler, and I kill you.
Not gonna spoil.
Okay, but I will say,
I loved it and it depressed me all at the same time. But
that I've already heard.
But I almost regret saying this.
I highly recommend it.
I pay attention to a DeviantArt artist named Jolly Jack, and he kind of spoiled some of it. Okay.
This is another one of the best. Yeah. So we used to kill the Mortig, and this is pretty much this one of the to do the quest.
Oh,
to get the ring.
Okay.
And it works exactly like the Mortig did. Let's see, what is it? It's Lost Mortig, Lost Aramite, Lost Laughlin. What's the third or fourth?
I don't remember. Okay, I've done that quest so many times, and then I can't remember. I almost need to Google that.
I'm trying to think.
Harfland spine, I will take. I have the heart. I now have the spine.
Yeah, that's fine. Mind you, the mission to do it once you've got it all is that solo only, if I recall?
What is?
The mission once you get all four items to Ergo?
No, that's not solo. You can team up.
And I know there's a nano that you could use to make it easier, but due to Funcom stupidity, I believe it used to require, if it doesn't, still require level 100 to use.
Yeah, I took one level character up to Ado once.
Just doing the ring quests?
Yeah, I've been having a 60 level into Inferno. But it's not something, it's basically something endgame people want to do because they've been doing so much and they're doing things to explore, right?
Yeah. My 150 fixer has his his final ring. Personally, I'm not too worried about the Halothlin spine or the Mortig hearts or anything.
Mm-hmm.
Because at the rate we've been going, we're gonna have the easy access to Shoal by the time we would have killed all four.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm very much for Ergo. I'd like my ring, please.
Yeah. Also remember when we pass to every single Ergo, getting the new ring, approved ring, you can delete the old one.
Yeah, I guess you can. I thought it usually required the ring to get the other one.
No, Ergo, you can
usually,
use
I thought it. Usually I thought Ergo usually asked for the previous ring, but
yeah, at the penumbra to Inferno he does. Then you need to deliver the molar and the ring at the same time.
Oh yeah, that's gonna be fun. When we're of level, we are gonna have to kill ourselves an ice golem.
Sounds like fun. Yeah.
Sweet.
All right.
Do we get to kill the frost giants too?
Do they look?
How about dark elves? Are there any dark elves we can mash in the face?
Do they look anything like City of Heroes?
When do we get to see Malnir in use?
So many hecklers.
I don't know, but later on you can get a copy of Excalibur.
Ooh, can't wait.
Woohoo!
Yeah.
But I assume I'm going to be disappointed because there's not going to be a mass immune.
Actually, this ward is pretty good.
Yeah, but mass immune is supposed to be better.
only if you listen to Japanese mythology.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Supposedly. At least according to Final Fantasy, and it's a popular enough franchise.
Speaking of Final Fantasy, we got to watch Brotherhood Final Fantasy 15. Actually, yeah. A pretty good series.
It wasn't bad. It was really true to their source. I'll say that.
Mm-hmm.
There was a couple of goofs, like making one character older than they should have been. But other than that,
mm-hmm.
It was written very well.
A lot better than the Blade and Soul anime we watched.
Wow. We were getting like 300 points of Guardian of Shadow earlier. Now we're getting like 70. yeah, we hit over 15k Guardian, so it's gonna start slowing down now.
Yeah, you can only reach that high faction in certain places, and when we reach a cap in Elysium, we need to move up to get more, basically, up on the map.
Yeah, we'll need to go to Shoal after that, and then we'll start getting more.
Yeah, and after that, we need to move to Adonis, and
the thing Nimbra. A lot of players, Shoal is nothing to them but a brief thing to pass through on the way to Edo. I actually love Shoal.
I think it looks cool, and
no,
I think we should.
Very cool.
And I think we should do the hecklers there. I think we should explore the hecklers from every place, because we tried Nassens and now we're doing Elysium, and we're gonna show them all basically, and see the how much harder they would be.
Well, I don't know. You,
trust me,
you know,
Inferno
you,
hecklers, that's hard.
Yes, I know. What I was saying is, you made Naz Hex look easy, and now you're making Ellie Hex look just as easy. So I'm not sure how much our people are gonna get to feel the difference.
So it'll be something.
Where did you go?
He's right over.
Did he go
Christer,
to
the bunch of stuff traveled down on us.
Hmm?
You tried to go up a hill and a whole bunch of monsters came down on us.
No, I just attacked them. They are like super low level, so we can just deal with them easy.
Mm-hmm.
Just letting you know, because it looked like to me like you were running off again.
Yeah, I was just jumping to aim a shot, shoot them in the
mm-hmm.
air.
Oh yeah, he was basically
these are Kalanas. They're basically the peons of Elysium.
They give a decent amount of XP because he dies so fast. We're currently walking towards East Fang, which is a great place for hecklers. Yeah.
Excalibur end.
Yeah, East Fang. Isn't that where the other Tig field is?
Yeah, that's where it is.
Yeah, it's been a while. I just remember trying to go to that field versus Callus, and it's a lot harder to not get whole spawns of Mortigs in.
You guys on the way?
Yeah, mm-hmm. There's just the Colana they're taking care of.
Okay.
And another one.
Just keep coming out of the woodwork right now.
Yeah, that's kind of Colanas for you. They're little aggro beasts. They're highly social.
Yeah. They might be weak, but they love to fight.
They love to fight, and they love to fight in packs. They're like velociraptors, only not as strong.
Kind of a cow.
And I think we should show this camp for hecklers, basically. It's kind of fun. It's like fire camps.
Ooh,
and then
frame rate drop.
Hecklers.
Alright, who got the heck? Or, excuse me, who got the voracious horror? Okay, we got it. It's on the right person.
Oh my god.
What? This hurting? Yes, it's hurting. I'm watching it take half your life off in one hit.
It's okay. Stick with us.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Okay.
Yeah, it's just, The mimic went off, so I was pretty weak.
Hey, you need to keep an eye on that timer a little more.
Yeah.
When it gets low, you gotta say, yeah, just give me a minute.
Yeah, it's just, I'm using the higher one, so it doesn't drain me as much. So I gotta cast, like, super much buff to cast it. I gotta go the MP and the lead buffs and rebuff and the lead buff.
That's the one I just got you?
No. I'm basically gonna refresh like 3 140 time buffs. Alright, I think we should try some Mortics again.
Okay.
I don't mind it, because you can take whole spawns of Mortigs.
Yeah, and they're pretty easy. Well, easy compared to LA Hex. I think Mortigs is rather difficult for a team at 60-ish.
Yeah, but we're now at, like,
we're
75.
Almost 80.
Yeah, we're almost 80. Yeah, my goal of 88 by the end of the night is probable.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm not getting cap off these guys anymore.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I'm gonna wind up having to do so much research.
And there's another Dojo chip that I can't touch.
Aww.
It looks like I can touch you!
Alright, so probably if after we end the stream tonight, the next one is probably going to be the beginning of Ellie Key Quest.
Plop.
Also, aside from Rogue One, I was out shopping today and happened upon a Lego set with Spider-Man and Ghost Rider.
There you go. Now you have two Ghost Riders Legos.
Yes, and this is one I've actually had on my wish list on Amazon for a while, and I decided to double check the pricing on it on Amazon, and it was at least $2 without shipping, more expensive on Amazon. Apparently it must have been selling like hotcakes over the winter season here.
After our last live stream, Ed and I tried multiplayer on Sentinels of the Multiverse. In fact, Ed went so far as to buy me the Season 1 expansion packs for it. And it's very enjoyable, especially if you played the original card game.
It's all right. Nothing particularly bad I can say about it thus far.
The music on it's wonderful. The music and atmosphere on it, it's great. So,
and I can get Bioshielding 3 again.
And the fact that the gameplay... Whoa, we've got a Voracious Horror. Heads up, people.
Big guy.
But yes, the gameplay goes a lot faster than playing it on the card version. Meaning the fact that in the course of about 3 hours, Ed and I managed to play about 5 games worth of it. Only 2 of which we won.
It also seems a lot harder. It's Danny. Wow, there's actually someone streaming this. I can't believe this game isn't free yet. It is kind of free to play.
The base game is free to play.
I'm surprised too that they haven't added the Shadowlands to free to play or added a in-store access or something to for zones.
Wasn't there
like
a thing you could play on Shadowlands for a limited time for free?
Yeah, there was a sloob system for a while. It didn't go over too well, so they ended it.
By the way, also MadMatt 2185, right, Matt, is also live streaming Anarchy Online.
It's actually part of this team, so
Same stream. He's Matt's right there on the keeper, not that guy. Keeper, there we go.
Me with my big shiny living sword.
For some reason, I can't click on.
And I'd stream, but our bandwidth is being horribly abused as it is. So that would be bad, Kay.
Yeah. It's Daniel65 says that he's not spending money on a subscription, and I can understand that, especially.
I have no money too, and I can understand not wanting to spend money. What the heck?
There are plenty of other games to play too.
Head of an Immortal.
I don't know what they were planning to ever do with that, but it never really got implemented.
Apparently the owner of the head must be dead, but it still feels very much alive. It's warm, and the cheeks are fresh. Hue and the eyes occasionally blinking.
Yeah, I remember we used to loot those to use them as references to make Highlander jokes.
that's what might be your thought was too. That can be only one.
Did you take it, Matt?
I took it.
Yeah, looted it.
Oh, here we go.
But it really other than making a reference of it to use in chat to make Highlander jokes. There was really no other use to it.
I honestly think these made it in the game just for a joke. I honestly think so.
There's several things there where the devs have had a sense of humor like that.
Yeah.
There can be only one keeper.
Very much, well, again, we've seen other MMOs that have references in them, like World of Warcraft had a reference to Whippet.
Oh yeah, there was there used to be a bot somewhere. I think it was in 10.3 that was essentially it was Marvin the Paranoid Android.
I don't know about paranoid. More Debbie Downer, the clinically depressed android.
That's what they called him, Marvin the Paranoid Android. Mm-hmm. I never knew. I know it never sounded right, but that's what they called him.
Well, and it's Trust. Daniel is not very impressed with MMOs nowadays. He's already reached 220 in this game. He said he heard Heroes had references to AO in background art.
It wouldn't surprise me. I know in Praetoria, one of the corporations in their Praetorian expansion was called Omnitech, and I swear to God it was an AO reference, but I couldn't tell you for certain. The devs never confirmed nor denied it.
They also had the frequent quest to pop up for finding the Hydrogen Destroyer, which is the weapon that destroyed Godzilla.
They were very much for references for about anything.
And, why are we running this way?
I don't know.
I don't know.
I was following the bots, actually.
Yeah, I don't know. Actually, Krister's back that way.
I keep seeing the Metaphysis as
I keep seeing both versions of Krister run past us.
Oh my. Mm-hmm. Oh my god. Yeah, maybe the MP lagged.
Yeah, I think so. Ah, damn it. Tried to keep you alive. Couldn't keep you alive fast enough.
Mm.
Oh god.
Whisper Cat died. Oh shit.
I'm about to die.
Hang on, let me calm it.
Okay, I'm not longer targeting.
It's calmed. Oh, something keeps attacking it.
Oh, I'm not attacking it.
What keeps egging this?
It's on me now.
He's mean and he's mad and he's really angry.
There.
Look at me, there. I'm a pocket.
He's calmed. Nobody attack that one. Until we're finished with this one.
Okay.
She'll head back. He or she.
Okay.
Possibly he. Woo!
Hi.
Damn it, Matt.
Ren had a mini heart attack.
I'm sitting here spamming heals to keep Ag on it, screaming, look at me, I have a pocket.
East Fang.
East Fang, indeed.
Can I put my bio cocoon on somebody else?
No,
you can't.
That would make it so much more useful.
That would be, I don't know if I want to say that would be very, very, OP per clone.
Because otherwise I feel like it's kind of useless right now.
No, your bio cocoon, Matt, is your oh shit button.
Yeah, right? But it's really not helping right now.
Well, the problem is...
As long as things are under control.
Well, the problem...
And later on, you're gonna feel like the bio cocoon doesn't have the same... It doesn't really have a long cooldown, so later, when you're able to survive certain things, you wanna use cocoon to time it so it spawns again, the cooldown goes up again, so you can maybe pop it like a few times in one fight. So you need to sometimes just think like, do I need to pop it, can I pop it now, or do I need to spare it sometimes? Sometimes you need to just judge.
Yeah, that's another level. What level am I?
Nice.
I'm 82.
I'm 81.
Ah, cool.
Six more.
Should we wait here? Levels.
Yeah, I'd say we wait here, but...
82.
Krister has run off ahead.
So. Oh, hey, yeah, head of an immortal. I have one now for my wall.
Well, does that mean that you and Matt must duel to the death?
I'm just putting this on my wall.
I dare you to use your robot against me.
Robot. Still can't do a Zoidberg impersonation.
And we can only combat each other while the music of Queen plays in the background.
Here we are.
Draw your sword.
You just flip the music on and off. It's like a red light, green light. Red light, green light. Super hot.
Super hot.
I didn't get that game yet.
Yeah, I don't have it either.
Oh.
I'm still trying to carve my way through Mass Effect. The original Mass Effect. And also watching Magical Girl Raising Project. That's a fun one.
That's
the one Bob was talking about, yeah. It's basically like Highlander, but with magical girls.
Speaking of Highlander... Oh.
Anyone else have any news going on?
Most of my stuff, other than the fact that I'm going to make the building the Ghost Rider bike into a video later at some point. It'll be just me aiming the camera at me building it on some sort of flat surface and just fast-forwarding it.
You're talking about, like, the Lego bike, not an actual bike, I take it.
Yeah, the Ghost Rider Lego bike, I just said.
For some reason, only the Ghost Rider bike came through, and I was just like, you're building an actual bike? I thought you just got a Lego set.
I wasn't a very big fan of the Ghost Rider movies.
The Ghost Rider movies are not where I am and why I'm a fan. The reason I'm a fan is because I actually read the comic books that started in the 90s, and they were fantastic.
I'm not a big fan of the second Ghost Rider movie, but only because I know Nicolas Cage too well. And his running dialogue in there made me have flashbacks to other Nicolas Cage movies.
Yeah, I mean, Nicolas Cage is a good actor.
But I just don't feel like this is quite the role he was looking for.
Well, I gotta say, the acting he did in the Treasure Hunt movies, the one and two, is very good.
He seemed to actually be enjoying those. Sadly, the first Ghost Rider movie was a hot mess, just idea-wise all around, and he was still not completely bought and sold when he was told he was going to do the second one, which was only going to touch on elements, not the whole plot of the first one. Which, some elements were right, but the whole plot of it was completely wrong. And they still didn't quite catch it. The problem is that you really can't do Ghost Rider as PG-13. You really can't.
Yeah, well that door has been blown open now by Deadpool, so...
Yes, so they should actually be kicking the doors down at this point.
Well, you can kind of do a PG-13 Ghost Rider, as we've seen on Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Well, I didn't feel like Nicolas Cage was the wrong actor. It's just, I didn't like the movie, basically.
I don't know. I don't remember much of anything about Ghost Rider 2, because I spent the entire time having Raising Arizona flashbacks. Because he's using the exact same voice and the exact same style narration.
Which hints at that he was liking it a little bit better than the first movie, but it still has some major flaws that I would just sit there and go, nope, at. Mm-hmm. Especially the fact that Dan Cage was that young of a kid and was obviously not going to be Johnny's little brother like he should be in continuity.
That doesn't bother me. Changes in continuity don't bother me for movies.
When it's that closely tied together, it does irk me.
I mean, God knows, even comic books can't keep their own continuity for that. DC in particular has made Lex's sister, like, sometimes his daughter. It's weird.
But when it comes to changes, I can understand reasonable ones, like the one that they did for the Ghost Rider and Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. They kept pretty much most of the character same until you get to the skull, and it's just like, isn't that supposed to be a biker helmet? And then from what little I understand of the background of him is that apparently he actually got in contact with one of the other writers and they put a spirit of vengeance into him, apparently.
Yeah, it
instead of
like
just ghost possession by his uncle.
It looked like it was supposed to be Johnny.
Which makes more sense.
It actually looked like it was Johnny Blaze himself.
It could be either of them. There wasn't a whole lot of detail on that one. I need to literally see his pants before I can actually tell you for sure which one it is. And even that might not tell me, because I think even Danny's outfit has changed. It's been 20 years. mm-hmm. It could have been either of the Blazes. It's hard to tell.
Yeah, I'm thinking though that they're gonna go into that more.
I hope so.
In the next half season.
Yeah, I really enjoyed Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. this season, so far.
There's not much in geek TV online at the or on TV at the moment. I'm not enjoying.
Mm-hmm. Like we're totally into the Arrowverse.
Flash, Arrow, Legends Supergirl. Of Tomorrow, Supergirl. Watch all of that. Like, religiously.
Yes, actually, it's Daniel. We do play other games. Like I said, we were playing Mass Effect. Or I was playing the original Mass Effect. And I actually really love it. Of course, I'm also more of a fan of talking to people in dialogue and just kind of figuring out storyline elements and stuff like that. I'm more of a fan of that than of combat, so...
When I'm still it depends on the kind of game. If they can combine both of them really well, that's great.
Mm-hmm.
When I'm not doing MMOs, I tend to be a console gamer, so I'll play a lot of the like Assassin's Creed style or.
I bought Final Fantasy 15 lately, so you've been playing that.
And I took
that.
It over.
Yeah, pretty much.
Well,
and that's the first time I've played a Final Fantasy game in since like 10. So.
It's my first Final Fantasy game ever, and I like it, actually. I wish I could play it more. Just kidding.
Well, I'm the person that plays a lot of different games, like MOBA games, MMO games, and first-person shooting games, and a lot of single-play games.
Would love
like
to have people to join me on Heroes of the Storm.
I'm okay with FPSs. I am not, however, a big fan of MOBAs.
I love Team Fortress 2.
Oh yeah, I had a lot of fun with Team Fortress 2.
Well, I'm a very big fan of competitive games.
Of you could join me in Verdun any day.
I'm a competitive person.
The reason I don't like MOBAs that much. Is I'm very much for lore and background information.
And yeah, you're not going to get that out of any MOBA ever. It's very shoestring no matter what one you look at. And to be honest, I'm fine with that as long as the game's actually fun to play. And when people start getting toxic, it's no longer fun to play, which is why Heroes of the Storm has been the one MOBA for me.
I mean, I was running around AO today. And I was trying to remember the lore and the stories behind Four Holes and 2HO and, you know, all the stuff that they had. And apparently they don't even keep online anymore.
Hmm.
Kind of made me sad that it wasn't... I couldn't look that stuff up.
I wonder where Whisper Cat is. Is she able to make it over here?
I didn't knew.
I haven't seen her in a while.
I wonder if maybe she's still on the team, right?
Yep. And was given coordinates.
Well, wonder if she's...
God, if...
Actually, has she sent any messages?
Look at the horizon. That looks really cool.
I do like this game and just how expansive the world feels. I just kind of wish it was a little more populated with stuff. With like dungeons or even just buildings you can go into. But, oh yeah, that's another thing. Other MMOs we play are Lord of the Rings Online. We just got done doing a whole series of live streams on the Secret World, World of Warcraft. We actually managed to get Randy into World of Warcraft after he said you
because
never
of the Warcraft
play it.
Movie.
Yeah.
Which was their intent.
Mm-hmm.
Which was their intent because they were also just on the verge of releasing Legion.
Mm-hmm.
And I hope they do that Warcraft 2 movie because it's going to be 10 times better.
I do like World of Warcraft to an extent, but that game, almost as much as AO needs work, WoW needs to go back and work on its earlier zones.
Yes, it really does. The continuity makes no sense anymore. It really needs to get hammered out again.
You don't need to break the world. You just need to, you know, take a wrench and fix up a few things, guys.
I also have done a series of articles for FunCurve.com about Guild Wars 2, basically a little narrative that my editor-in-chief there wanted me to write, so that was pretty cool. It was we went through Heart of Thorns with Matt, and Matt, I'm sure, had a few aneurysms.
Oh. I have an aneurysm of sheer stupidity of this game. What is this level design? Rotten hell, Thorns.
Oh, come on. You liked the glider. Gliding through the jungle and everything. I just hated the fact that I had to earn it, but makes sense that you have
to. The level design was still bullshit. That doesn't take it away from the fact that the mapping was completely bupkis.
I can't stand Guild Wars 2 personally.
The rest of Guild Wars 2, as far as I'm aware, I'm perfectly fine with.
No,
it's just the level design for that last
The way they have the quests randomly pop up and stuff made me feel real disconnected from it.
That's just kind of the random side stuff.
It didn't give me a sense of story or anything. I was half the time wandering around not really sure what I should be doing. It just, I don't know, it didn't click with me.
I like it. I mean, it's definitely not an easy game, but it is kind of one of my favorites.
Oh, speaking of MMOs, actually, I just saw that Digimon got one.
Oh,
on
geez.
Steam, and it's a free-to-play.
Oh, Jesus. My God. I mean, I'm kind of intrigued. I didn't hate Digimon, but again, it's...
And it's based on the first series.
Well, gee, you know, don't tell Adam.
I think he already knows about it, actually.
I wouldn't be surprised
if
he does.
We'll never see
right
him
now.
Again.
Bye, Adam.
Adam
has been
he lived
Digimon
a Digimon addict
for like a decade.
Yeah, Adam is a Digimon addict, and he has been the on again, off again con chair for GeekCon, which most of us are staffers for. Me, Matt, and Randy, we're all staffers.
I'm even a department head.
It's Daniel 65 says he played Digimon for 5 minutes and quit.
Oh boy.
I can understand that.
It depends on how the game goes. I would have to try it out firsthand to say what the disconnect is. But I was intrigued, but also at the same time, I'm like, how do you make the first series into an MMO? I have to ask.
I can understand like a Digimon just general MMO, but I don't know if I'd be interested.
But it looks like it's forcing you to play one of the characters from the first season. That makes me also raise my eyebrow.
Hate that. I want to make my own character. I don't need
I want to make my own Digimon trainer. Thanks very much.
Saboteur's armor gloves. Okay.
It's just stuff that drops. It's decent if you don't have any other armor, but it's really not great. And really, you know, for Shadowlands, what they really try to point you to is to get Job armor for Tyr, which is expensive, by the way, and a pain in the ass. Is Tyr armor really, and minus-sided, Krister, is Tyr armor any good for any of the professions anymore? Or is it just completely outclassed by OFAB?
Well, it's outclassed by OFAB. Well, I do think we are going to do the tier one. Tier one is not that difficult and doesn't take that much time, and I think that would be fun for us. I'm gonna pay for the Job armor.
Okay.
So don't worry about that.
I actually got tier 2 metaphysicist on my metaphysicist, not to wear, just to soch, because I thought it looked pretty good.
Yeah, because it looks badass, yeah. There's certain profession I say you need to do the tier just because it looks so badass. It's like Fixer, MT, Ancient, MP, and...
Really, the Fixer tier looks good?
Yeah, not really the Fixer 1, but the Fixer 3 looks so badass.
which is unfortunately sighted. So.
Yeah, well, the fixture 2 looks bad. Pretty much. It doesn't look bad. It looks cool. It's just. Tier 3 just looks more badass, basically.
Ooh, the Tarrasque will be up and will be attackable in 30 minutes. Let's go do the Tarrasque. Not.
I wouldn't mind doing the Tarrasque.
No, you're neutral. You don't get to do Tarrasque.
Actually, that's not true.
Really?
Yeah, woo-hoo! I can get you into Helcom. It's just you guys basically need to. You can be neutral and do Tara. It's just you need to be fighting clans, basically. I mean, if you support fighting clans, then I can get you into Helcom.
Yeah, that's kind of my problem, is I'm not for fighting clans. I'm not for fighting Omni. I'm just, you know.
Okay, heal me a lot, please.
Calming.
Here's inbound.
Calming.
Calm.
Nice. Good job.
Nice.
We made it.
We're gonna make it after.
Yeah.
Actually, I did attack both with intention.
Trying to keep me on my toes.
It was just tempting. Sorry. But then I started to think, like, this might be bad. Yeah, 2 hecklers is still a little bit too, it's still a bit much. We know.
So E2, I'm about to hit A3. Don't think it's gonna be this
I'm
one,
84.
I think it's probably gonna be a couple more.
Already 84, yeah.
No rain.
Whisper cat is almost 100.
Jeez, wow. I'm glad we could help.
Yeah, she just wants to join us because she knows that we're streaming and we got a decent team going on and just need a little extra oomph to kill these things.
I don't think she knew we were streaming, guys. I think she
It's not that. Leveling a shade can be painful.
Yeah.
Until you're about level 180, it's not a lot of fun.
Hey, it's a devil leap. This guy got a pitchfork tail and everything. So cute.
It's more fun than it used to be. A few years ago, when shades couldn't wear armor, they couldn't have token boards. Whereas shades were locked out of a lot of things, it was absolutely teeth pulling terrible to level a shade between, like, I would say 50 and 180.
If he wasn't super rich, it's like alien armor, but you can't expect everyone to afford it. I think Lost Eden, the armor was great to release, but I don't think Lost Eden was a good expansion. But I think that UFA was a good release. It's just I don't think the Lost Eden was a good expansion.
What about Lost Eden did you not like? Because Lost Eden added the battle stations, it added the OFAB armor, and it added the research lines.
By the way, InfoHip is wondering if any of us want some NT Lev.
Well, he's speaking about power leveling, basically.
Yeah.
I think he's meaning that. I mean, if you want to join, we have one room for, like, damaging, but I guess...
If you can get out of here.
If he means kiting, that would be pretty...
That's pretty boring for a stream.
Yeah.
All we're doing would be sitting on Kite Hill talking.
Or not necessarily kiter, it can be East Fang.
Yeah, I know. But whenever I think of kiting, it automatically thinks of Kite Hill.
Yeah.
I mean, it just immediately pops into the mind.
No, info hip means NT buffs. PNH or IOR.
Yeah, I could need some anti buff. I'm pretty.
I think I would be good with a PNH at this point, because yeah.
PNH would be nice.
I am like.
You have no
absolutely
nano.
hemorrhaging nano. And as much as I would like to keep saying I need to sit down and read nano, we're always in the middle of a conversation when Krister finishes something.
Yeah. Also, the mimic gives me Adnan cost 70.
God.
It's a lot. I guess the first mimic is 150. 150.
Oh God.
Yeah.
I would not want to think what that would do to my heals. They're eating enough of my nano already.
He's wondering if we're at P7. We're at East Fang, isn't it?
Yeah, East Fang. It's gonna be better. It's definitely gonna be better next one, because it's gonna go from 50 to 15. So it's gonna be so much better.
Yeah, we're north of Remains and East Fang on the big water track.
We're in East Fang, right up against the border with Remnans.
Watch out for the big stone
right
golems.
Right up on the canyon here.
Watch out for them big old stony hecklers. They're everywhere out here.
Well, Lisfer, welcome to title level 4. Last chance to do Foreman's if you need it.
Do we need it?
I wouldn't mind it for the stream, if nothing else.
Yeah, but we still have a far away from 100.
Yeah, we're still 10 levels to go.
I mean, it would be nice to reach 90, so we could actually do Foreman's.
I wouldn't mind it. I wouldn't mind Foreman's key quest for Ellie, just for convenience. And being able to just grab my ring for Shoal. And plus, that's going to make that really easy to... we want to do it because we want to stream it for the, you know, for the record.
Yeah. Level 90 will be nice.
That means I can put in those 88 sims without issue.
Info Hip says East Fang is an old school spot.
It is.
Yeah. Well.
Yeah. Well, we were down below P7, but it was being pocketed pretty heavily down there, so we decided to go someplace else.
Yeah. Also, it reminds of old memories. At the East Fang.
I have gained many a level here in East Fang. Many a tune, actually.
Whew.
I'm imagining...
Level 85.
I'll take that. Won't be a lot, but it'll be at least some cash. Dosh, boys, get it while you can. For some reason, I'm hearing Krister's character grunting really loudly right now. Oh!
It's because he's getting he's getting pounded on by hecklers.
Yeah, but I hadn't really noticed it until now. All of a sudden, his character got very vocal on my end.
The character sound is pretty good. Have you ever had like a mob dying in front of you, and you think it's your character dying?
Yes, mm-hmm. I actually.
Once in a while.
The beast run that we tried to do yesterday.
Yeah, the hisses.
Yeah, that when the hisses dies, it's like, is that the doc dying again? God damn it!
Well, the hisses is annoying. It's pretty annoying because the
and we have reached the edge.
Yeah, the make that sound, the dying sound to a character.
Oh, hi,
Matt.
Yep, backing up. Oh, hey.
Yeah, we don't want his orchestra.
Hey, the music actually kicked in this time.
Now, I think I was mentioning earlier before, like, the stuff hit the fan, I was looking at support sims, and I absolutely despise their actual physical drop level range. Is the fact that you've got the support symbiont, like, the head drops at, like, woo-hoo, 20, 120, 190, and then it drops, like, every 10 or 20 levels up after that, so...
I'm 184.
Nice.
I'm at 84. Blah.
Almost.
Yeah, you're 184. It's like, how are you in this team, Matt?
I am 184. I'm almost done playing the game.
Why are you not in Inferno?
I will destroy you all.
Oh, I can feel that Notum Harvester kicking in already, which is good because I might have to heal Krister.
Oh. And here we go. And promenade.
Oh, I haven't even looked at my nanos for a while.
Yep.
Let's put all the points in the world into nano pool. Thank you very much for the PNH.
Yeah, thank you, mate.
Yay!
Oh, I can feel it trickling in already.
Three, two, one, extra for everybody.
Yay!
Making sure that's been re-upped. Can I re-up this? Not the moment, apparently.
Can't wait till I'm higher level and actually have, you know, Nana Delta to spare. From what I understand, if you're an endgame duck and you're running out of nano, you've built him wrong.
Yeah. Depends. I mean, the duck can choose to run out, and he can also decide to run out.
Well, but yeah. I mean, you should not. I mean, you should have enough clickies or whatever that you're not innately running out of nano, like I am right now. Before the PNH.
Well,
you're just hemorrhaging.
You don't have enough clickies at 220 to keep your mana up, but you have enough nano delta to keep it up.
Okay.
But Doctor, I also have a perk line which will drain your mana, and it won't stop before you empty.
Okay.
The perk is good to a certain degree because it will increase your healing percentage. So you will heal more, but you will drain your mana. So you offer something for healing more. It's sometimes risky to perk it. Use the perk because, well, when you're empty, then you don't have mana, right?
Mm-hmm.
But it can be good. I mean, if you really need a heal, it can be good, but you need to make sure not just perk it, just to perk it. Also, if you are using your dots a lot at 220, you can't keep your dots 100% on and not run out of mana for a long time. I mean, you can keep them on for like a 5 minutes or something, but if you keep running all three dots all the time and you spam heal, You're gonna lose the mana after some time, but it's gonna take some time because Doctor have a lot of mana, so it's gonna take some time to lose all that. But you're losing slowly.
Hi there.
So earlier people were asking what kind of games we play. I only mentioned a couple of things. Here's the Storm is probably my pick for MOBA. Lately for first-person shooter games, I have been playing Verdun, which has been having its ups and its downs.
Mm-hmm.
When the game clicks with you strategy-wise, you really do get it.
Mm-hmm.
And I've had miracle moments where I literally accidentally sniper shoot a guy in the head with a pistol from a quarter of the map away and just go, oh, so I just did that and go back down to my hole.
Get back in your hole.
I've also had moments where we're trying to keep a trench and you can just see where these guys from the other team are jumping around like a really bad World War One whack-a-mole and just like, okay, I'm the leader, so we're dropping a nuke here on Hamburger Hill. Drop, walk into the trench, boom, three guys dead. Well, I seem to have hit somebody. I didn't even need to use my lipstick gun. Outside of that, what have I been doing? Oh, I've been playing Fallout for my channel. I've also been playing, Fallout, by the way, is a turn-based RPG, the original one.
The one of which Fallout 3 and its like is based off of.
Oh, yeah. I've also been playing Freedom Planet, and once Fallout is done, Freedom Planet will be going to my weekends for multiple episodes, and then I will be picking up Shadowgate, the remake, which was remade by the actual original creators of the series.
Oh, did we actually vote on anything yet?
Vote on what?
On any of your next Let's Plays. For after Fallout.
For after Fallout, it was Library Madness, Stefan, who voted for Freedom Planet, which, like I said, is 1 week right now until Fallout's done, which Fallout, I finally got the power armor. It's not going to take too terribly long before I'm actually done with that now.
Oh, wow.
It's literally the last couple of dungeons / bosses, and then it's over.
All right. I didn't realize it was so short. I'm used to, like,
I know how to get to the main points of parts of the game, and anything I don't know, I'll research quickly in between episodes and figure out what the next step is.
Okay, yeah, because I've always...
Getting the power armor is as simple as saving a guy from the Brotherhood of Steel from the hub.
Okay, yeah, because I've only watched the first three episodes of that. I've gotten caught up in other things. Like, today I spent most of my day writing. I wrote about, you know... 1500,
I have to double check. I think I'm close to 20 episodes.
It's quite a bit for me to write, so.
Yeah, but yeah, I'm close to 20 episodes on that, and it should be done before I hit 30, I think.
Sweet.
Freedom Planet was voted for by Stefan after that, and then Tim voted for me to play the remake of Shadowgate, which I have played the original on my channel if you ever want to watch that, too. I actually played the original in Game Boy Color format. It's essentially the same game, but re-upped visuals just slightly.
Okay, yeah, because I watched your Verdun playthrough.
Yeah, my one Verdun video, which was fun, but I still don't know a whole heck of a lot about it, other than it's occasionally fun to play.
Mm-hmm.
On my free time, what else have I been doing? I've been playing Minecraft off and on. Since 1.10 came around, I have yet to be able to get to end game for Minecraft. The change in combat kind of ruined things for me, to be honest. There's a lot of necessary things that were added that I really do enjoy, like the shields, but the sword play is really kind of annoying because you gotta wait for it to recharge before you swing again.
Yeah, it actually doesn't bother me once I figured out the knack behind it.
it still bothers the hell out of me because I just want to go in there swinging and actually kill something. I have to sit here with my shield up the entire time, and I also have to worry about being knocked off ledges all of the time.
Matt just wants to smash stuff.
Yeah.
I want to find your face, and I want to beat it in.
Matt's response to things in that was to basically hit it and going, bat, 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 bat.
That's kind of Matt's response to stuff in, like, Uncharted Waters where it's all about diplomacy. I'm just going to come and kill you now.
Diplomacy? No, who needs this? I'm a pirate.
Actually, it's not really that. It's about building yourself up so you can be a pirate. Mm-hmm. But you wanted to come out of the gate swinging, and...
Because any other MMO like it would come let me come out of the boat swinging. Ooh, we got another sheet of Perineum. 153, though.
Yeah, that's one's okay for, like, a 153 beamer.
Yeah, I got Perineum bolts there at 196 now.
Well, with the bolts and the sheets, we got enough to make a 200 gun. Well, I'll have to run a 200 rifle.
The sheet doesn't decide the quality, it's a weapon.
No, but the sheet has to be within 80% of the quality. That's a general trade skilling rule.
Not to everything.
No. But it's a general rule. And as far as I remember, it did apply to Perineum.
You know, is experiment and find out.
I know there are some things that are different. I know, for instance... putting clusters in an implant is different quality based on whether it's shiny, bright, or faded.
Yeah, it changes. So if you want to make three inner quality implants, you can use a 290 implant and go for 253 cluster, 256 cluster, and 259 cluster.
Change things up with some nukes.
You also need and programming and another trade skill.
Then you bump them.
Yep.
Also higher. A lot of things will affect the bumping, depending on how much trade skill you have, and also how big quality of the clusters and. The max quality of bumping is fire level each cluster.
Yeah. And then there are some trade skills in this game that make no sense. The fact that you can make Devalo sleeves, yet the quality of the sleeve is based on the quality of the powder, not the quality of the sleeve you dip it in, always bugged me.
Yeah, but wait, you can use the bot for, like, finding, like, certain trade skills as well. Which is pretty handy. If you want trade skills from alien armor, you can find it in the bot, basically.
Seems like my nose is finally calmed down.
Oh, I was gonna say, I haven't heard you sneeze in the past hour or so.
What time is it?
It's about
10:30.
10:20. We did start late, too.
How late?
Just a little bit. Like, I think we were trying to get started at 7, and we started at 7:30.
Okay. So we've been doing this now for 3 hours.
Just about.
Which means a couple of these episodes are going to run long, which means I need to download the entire stream to my hard drive.
Hey, but we're going to come out of this right about where we want to be. In those 80s, so I can start looking at Sims for everybody!
Sims!
Sims, salabim!
Where I have to open up Backyard Doc shop and go, okay, what do I got? What can I fit you in? Come here.
What Hanna-Barbera cartoon was that from again? I can't remember now.
That's what? From Johnny Quest.
That was from Johnny Quest?
Yes.
Okay.
That
Bim
was,
Sim Salabim. That yeah. was Haji.
That was
Haji using his powers. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. Okay.
Bad Matt forgetting Johnny Quest.
No, I knew it came from, I knew at least it was Hanna-Barbera. I just couldn't remember which one.
To be honest, I was always more a fan of Real Adventures than I was the old classic stuff. And I know, that's bad me.
What, actually, Real Adventures was actually pretty good.
Second season was better than first.
I like the one movie that they came out where they actually delve into the death of Johnny's mother and how it all ties in with Dr. Sin.
That's right, they did that too, didn't they?
Yeah, and they introduced Reese's daughter. That's when they first introduced
that
her.
That was first introduced her, and then she was part of the Real Adventures afterwards.
Yeah, and the Real Adventures, they were older, though. They were, like, older teens.
Slightly
almost.
Older,
yeah. Yeah, I think that movie you're talking about came out in the 80s.
No, it came out in the 90s. Like,
it came out in, like, the really early 90s.
Yeah,
and
early 90s.
It was a special on Cartoon Network and everything. Because at the time, Cartoon Network played nothing but Hanna-Barbera half the day anyway.
Well, that was because that's what they owned. It's because Cartoon Network was owned by Ted Turner, and Ted Turner bought Hanna-Barbera. And then sold it to Warner Brothers, which is, you know, what owns Cartoon Network to this day.
And they've had some hits and they've had some misses since.
So apparently,
yeah, they've had good eras, they've had bad eras, and they're just coming down from a good era now.
I think I hit them a pretty long stretch of bad, and I just kind of never went back.
Adventure Time is considered a good era of Cartoon Network.
I love Venture Brothers on Adult Swim.
Oh, yeah.
And Venture Brothers has always been amusing from what I've seen of it.
But,
I think Venture Brothers was on during the last year or so that I was watching it.
Yeah, next time you're in town, Matt, that's what we'll have to sit down and marathon for you.
Unless we can get season 2 Rick and Morty?
I don't even know if that's out yet. I mean it's out. I don't know if it's out for, like, DVD or anything. I don't know if Netflix has it.
Well, you ask someone who has a Netflix account that's active.
Or Hulu.
Well, I have a Netflix account active.
We don't at the moment because we shut it down for the holidays because, you know, holiday presents are expensive.
Netflix, all right,
so
bros.
Johnny's Golden Quest is the telefilm that we were talking about. It was a feature-length television movie in 1993, and then there was a follow-up movie, Johnny Quest versus the Cyber Insects, for 1995.
That's right. Okay.
I think it still starred. It had Reese's daughter in that too.
Oh, Pernambrum 195. In the one that we just killed.
What?
195. The metal.
Oh shit! I did not mean to attack that.
You gotta watch what you're attacking.
It's not fine. Oh my god.
It's not?
Maybe.
Okay, she got to go to sleep.
Whew. Sorry about that. I was going to turn back to the one, to loot the one, and then I was also talking about Johnny Quest, and then I was talking about everything else, and did not see which one I had targeted. I thought I had targeted this one.
Gave Krister a heart attack.
It's okay,
Krister. Yeah, tab targeting bad, Aaron.
That's the only way I can actually click on stuff nowadays.
That's like the worst option we've got because we could end up clicking on Krister instead.
My health were moving a little bit too close to comfort.
Like, I'm trying to click on them with my mouse, but with all the pets and stuff in the way, I can't get to them.
So that way I can make sure I get to them because if I tap target, it picks the wrong thing all the time.
I just have to cycle my tab targeting. But no, I wasn't even looking at what I had targeted before I found
There we
Very
go.
Very bad, Aaron. Very bad, Aaron. That is a way to
cool.
die in a heck
Ooh,
field.
Ooh, hey, look at that. Minion Ice Pulse Pistol. No drop.
Rick and Morty show DVD only. Son of a bitch.
Range energy from 963. Yeah, I'll pick it up.
DVD only for Rick and Morty on Netflix.
Yeah.
Sucks, because I would love to watch the second season by now.
Yep, and then The Real Adventures of Johnny Quest was 1997.
Yep.
So there's a couple years after that last movie.
It ran until 1999 with a DVD coming out in 2009.
Yeah, I knew that one. I knew that one because I remembered that from because it used to be on the tail end of Toonami.
That was when I was getting really big into both sci-fi and Cartoon Network at the time.
But,
those were pretty much my two stations until the early 2000s. Then both of them just started going downhill.
Yeah, the end of the Cartoon era was when Cartoon Network went downhill for a while.
And what makes me even more sad is you could actually find the old promos for sci-fi, and it makes me long for the good old days. Remember when they used to have actual sci-fi stars come on and guest host stuff?
Yes.
Literally, one of the clips is Mark Hamill in front of multiple images of Jet Jaguar from Godzilla.
Mm.
And it's just like,
I love the Jet Jaguar from Godzilla. I just thought it was so cool. And for the longest time, I thought it was the same as Ultraman.
He's an XP. Essentially, the kid. It was actually a one of those have the kids put in a thing and we'll make it in a movie. And essentially, it was a knockoff of Ultraman and something else. I think it might have been Red Baron, but I'm not sure. But they got to fix up the design and a little bit of the ideas behind, but they still didn't really understand how to do it right. But they did well for 70s camp.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because I remember watching Johnny Soko and his amazing flying robot.
Johnny Soko.
Amazing giant robot.
Amazing giant
robot. I know, because I have a tune named after him. My engineer, Johnny Soko.
But
who, if you click on him, you discover his actual name listed there is Daisaku Kusama.
But yeah,
which is the Japanese name of Johnny Soko.
There's also actually a Godzilla game for PlayStation 2, Godzilla Save the Earth, or Battle for Earth. Actually, I think it was Battle for Earth. And Jet Jaguar is actually, for the first time, a playable monster in that game, and you can make him larger or smaller. You make him so large that he literally just karate chops at any of the monsters in the face and they go flying. Or you can make him so small that he'll just super speed run at them and punch them in the knees.
Take him out in the news. Yeah, I don't know why I've been on an anime kick. I've been on a writing kick lately.
She has been. She wrote something in the vicinity of 3,000 to 4,000 words today.
No, it was more like 1,500 to 2,000. That's not much for people for like actual writers.
Really? I thought you wrote 2,000-word reviews.
Might have been that.
And then you wrote some more on your on the other thing that you're working on.
I wrote about, I don't know, about 1,000 words on the Fun Curve article for the history of Studio Ghibli, which needs to be edited down to 500 words. And then I wrote another almost 1,500-word review on Yuri on Ice, and that still isn't done.
That's 2,000. And then you did a review on Brotherhood.
About 500 words so far.
So that's 2,500 at least. Aha, wasn't so far off, was I?
Yeah. I mean, that's not much compared to people who, you know, write 10,000 words in one day, but...
Yes, those are called novelists. I try to do that. I can't do that.
Yeah.
You keep keeping writer's block as your problem with that.
Oh, yeah, my writer's block is huge. It's more like a writer's wall at this point. Every now and then I'll sit down and I'll work on about a sentence and a half, and that takes me about 3 hours.
And people are just tuning in the truckloads of 30 to 40 just to listen to us ramble.
Hey, we're grinding.
Our grinding has literally turned into a talk show.
That's what grind. That if you've ever watched people that do streams like this, that's kind of what grinding does. You got to keep yourself talking to keep yourself from going zombified. And that's 88, by the way. So that's Symbionts.
Oh yeah, I'm in 88 as well.
87, I just hit it.
That's 120 Sims. So I can actually put in my support brain, which is currently on my adventurer, so I'm going to take that off of her brain and throw it in mine.
But yeah, speaking of that Lego too, by the way, the one I got originally at OdysseyCon wasn't too bad, but I noticed the chain was awfully short. This one definitely has a chain, not only just a chain, but a fire chain that could easily wrap around him.
Huh.
So I'm just like, ooh. And it's got a big bike that's like three times bigger than him.
When they were talking coming about out of that, it. When they were talking about getting that Vault Zero in as a vendor, I'm not quite sure if they're legit.
Vault Zero?
I think that's the one you bought your Lego from, was Vault Zero.
That one? No, actually that is a legit Lego, but it was part of a set of other bike wielding characters. But that is a legit Lego I've seen on sale.
Oh, okay.
There's also Spider-Man and a Captain America and a couple others that are part of the set.
And at 88, I have now hit title cap for all my green skills. That means for the next 12 levels, I can't raise crap all on anything important other than my stats.
And Vexy just gave us an emote with a thumbs up.
Yay!
Hey. Oh.
Don't fall off the ledge.
Don't whiz on the
I think I've finally gotten fence. It so that I can actually pick up on some more subtle sounds. I had my sound turned down so low you couldn't really hear anything.
Yeah, you sounds are a very good indicator of stuff going on.
Yeah.
Well, no, I just wanted to pick up on like some of the dialogue and stuff that was being said, or some of the grunts and little sounds that I was missing out on. Like, for example, the Udo, back by Ergo. I kind of wanted to hear that, but I couldn't.
Okay. Still getting cap XP.
It's going to be cap XP for the time.
They're by no means small guys that we're fighting out here.
I almost want to turn some research on, but I'm going to skip that for now. Because I'm already still behind Aaron.
I did it, because it's cap.
About what percentage?
Depends which research you're doing.
Two.
Two, I would do 30%. I think something about 30%.
Oh,
I have 15% because I'm doing the bird.
Yeah, I went out to try to do my research on my own and reminded myself that I'm a doc that can't currently do crap.
Also, actually, something to mention in gaming, now that I happen to just think about it, I recently purchased Postal Redux. Some people may know Postal mostly from Postal 2, which was the really crazy tongue-in-cheek open-world first-person game.
Mm-hmm.
But the first Postal was actually kind of serious, because it kind of seemed to hint that either the main character or the people around him were actually crazy.
That's capping both research and straight XP.
I turned my research 25%, and I'm doing the third research, so I think you could turn a little bit more.
Mm.
Yeah, 25 is still cap for me.
Okay, I'm gonna try upping it to.
I would do 45.
But so I just got Redux. I played the original. My original thought on the original was that it's a pretty solid game for being the age that it is, but the controls have aged really poorly. Redux has literally fixed every problem I had with the original, and has added multiplayer. So you can either team up to actually play the entire game, or you can actually do they just added in literally this month multiplayer versus.
Doesn't make a difference, Krister. 30 or 45, I'm capping both my research and my XP. So.
Yeah, it's just very high mobs for us, for our level. It's just, it's not meant for doing at this level.
Oh, wow, there's like.
Yeah, gigantic.
I don't mind if you don't. I won't tell Funcom if you won't.
I just hit 89, by the way.
Yeah, I just hit 90.
I'm just about a quarter of the way away from hitting 88.
Yeah, I think we're gonna call it when Matt get 88.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Remember,
88 gets us 89. Because we got doges, so.
Yeah.
True.
Or in my case, 90. No.
Whatever level we wind up with will become one level higher by turning in a dojo.
Okay, definitely within the last quarter now. Oh, it just feels like we've been doing this forever and yet not at all at the same time. Thinking I'm just also finally recovering from allergies, so I'm just finding this well strength that I'm no longer burning trying to feel better.
Well, yeah, I think we can actually just deliver the ship and the Elysium ship.
And call it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because I'm getting a little bit sleepy, actually.
What time is it over by you, Krister? You're in Norway.
It's getting close to 6 o'clock.
In the morning?
Yeah.
We got heck egg.
Yeah, okay, let's kill Repop. This.
I need this for my 88. Give me your soul.
No, we're carving it down so quick here.
Yep.
One of my coworkers has been playing Perfect World International, and all the grinding of the hex kind of reminds me of that game.
Oh, God. I haven't played PWI in years, and it just got so samey grindy.
Oh,
I couldn't stand it anymore.
I was actually going
run around
zombie.
This area, fight the same monsters 50 times over and barely get half the items you're looking for.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Well, I'm just gonna say, when it comes to grinding, this is actually not grinding. This is not actually called grinding.
It's grinding.
When you get to level 160 and still doing ado hecklers, then you will feel like grinding.
Look what I managed to do.
Because things what? Getting slower and slower.
Look up here.
Getting slower and slower.
Oh, you got up on top of the thingies. God damn it. So jelly now.
Yeah, so I think we're gonna move to the statue or something. It's gonna be faster. Actually, we can use the recoil beacon.
Matt does not have one.
Okay, then we run together.
That is why my normal shortcuts for doing stuff I haven't done is because Matt does not have enough vet points to merit a recall beacon. I don't know if he has any vet points.
Well, you won't get he won't get veteran points anymore because the
they stopped giving you veteran points. Yeah, and he doesn't have enough Funcom points to buy a recall beacon, and if he did, he might not spend it on a recall beacon.
Yeah.
All right. So.
Yeah, but this is actually not like grinding yet. It's gonna be much, much slower.
It's gonna just be a longer grind.
No, you're wrong. Grinding. This is grinding. It just is harder grinding. Up there. Anytime you're doing the same thing repeatedly for XP. It's technically grinding. It's just, this is easy grinding compared to 80 Hex. I'm well aware of that.
I just can't call it grinding because it's going so fast.
InfoHip wants to say, once you start doing Inferno missions, you will know what grinding is.
Oh, no shit.
Well,
No. When you start trying to do the Shire missions, you know what grinding is. No.
Shire missions are crap all, because you're only doing them once and going through them. This is a completely different animal, where you pull a mission to go into the same base and do the same thing over and over and over and over and over and over and over. And finally, after doing it for 4 hours, you've gained one level.
Why did he hop down there? Okay.
Well, I didn't mean to. I was using the other two MPs and
you got yourself stuck?
Nah, I just turned out to run on the ancient.
Inferno missions, you grind until your teeth bleed.
Well, it's the most grinding it comes to Anakin line, it's the Addo Heckler part. It's even slower than Inferno mission. It is. I mean, I've proven it to so many players. Doing Inferno mission, it actually doesn't take that much of time. It's not that bad.
It's still grinding because you're still just constantly running missions for something.
Well, as long as it doesn't take much time, then I wouldn't consider it grinding.
That does not define grinding. How much time it takes. It's
well,
again,
me,
grinding is literally the repeating of the same thing over and over again to try and meet an end goal, which is mostly usually leveling.
Yeah, but you're leveling so fast, basically.
It doesn't matter how fast you do it, it's still grinding. It's just grinding harder.
All right, Matt. I'm not gonna fight
on
this.
I think you're on your own on this one, Krister. But I do know what you're getting at.
Yeah,
it's gonna be a really hard, really long grind.
As a real veteran player, I can't say this is great. It's just
you're just being hipster about grinding.
Next time, Krister, just watch. Next time, Krister will be leading you off of one of these bridges.
I'll just look down first and go.
Hey, I was attacked by a bunch of hecklers. Here they all come. Right up behind Randy.
Careful, Matt. I know, a bunch of ways for you to die in this game.
And you would never know it was Krister who did it.
I am well aware of all the ways I could die. One of which is by the hecklers that are currently chasing me. I told you, crossing bridges in this zone is not safe.
Oh, I just saw an XP drop up.
Yeah, me too.
Somebody killed something nearby.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I see. There's a few mobs there.
That was
there.
A Haloflin. Okay.
Yeah.
Attacked by Heckler of Stones.
Attacked by Heckler, 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 Heckler. Venomous Horror, Heckler, Heckler.
From the mountain.
Ow! Ow! My face! My ass!
Remember, we don't have the MPs anymore.
Yeah, I was spamming group because everybody was damaged after that. Oh.
I see. We don't need MPs anymore to kill a hack.
Alright, so once InfoHip says, once you reach 2015 plus, Inferno missions are super slow. 80 Hex go by pretty fast because there are more things to do. Once you get to 200 plus, you can basically only do Inferno missions. The Edo Hex level range, not just Edo Hex level.
The pink white, it doesn't take so much time at 215 plus. It's basically because rewards gives you so much SK as a mission rewards.
I mean, I didn't have a hard time between 215 and 220.
Yeah.
The addition of the daily missions, as much as you hate them, helped with that, because it was daily mission, prisoner's mission, inf team.
Yeah, and take it from someone that leveled to 220 before the daily mission were released. You didn't do daily mission and you didn't need it. The inferno mission was good enough. It wasn't even slow. You could do it pretty fast.
By the way, but you managed to finish my research with all of that. At least that particular tier too. I mean, I've got a bit more.
Yeah.
Let me switch over to rehabilitation too. But
do we have someone else that's running our group now?
Or is it? Oh, just Mastering Infinity is following us.
Huh.
Okay. Well, probably because we're all heading back to Job here.
Job.
Going up the ramp.
So if I were to.
Did you just snipe a guard?
I just sniped a guard.
You better run.
You ass. You jackass.
Nothing to worry about.
Yeah.
I mean, as long as you don't heal me, you won't get ag.
No, it wasn't that. I have some bad memories about people attacking guards back in 2002 when I was a newbie leveling outside of Newland City. I would occasionally get in over my head, and of course the immediate action is to run back to the guards while it's safe. Well, you know, 200 assholes used to go up and just kill those guards just because they could. So, you know, imagine me trying to run back there to safety and suddenly the guards weren't there, and I would die by, you know, overly aggressive roller rat or whatever the hell lagged me right there.
Where'd everybody go?
I was heading back to the portal to Job platform so I could go down to the research level.
Oh.
Yeah, you want to go north. Up the stairs,
okay. To the Job research, and then west north.
You basically you go up the stairs until you around the building, yeah, north west north. And then over there you see the Job platform with a little ring on it. You hit that, and it gives you the wonderful Stargate style teleport. And then you can head over here to the harbor.
Harbor.
Doja.
Because, you know, it wouldn't be the end of a stream if we didn't randomly have something go catastrophically wrong, if I can speak English tonight.
Well, don't curse us, Matt. and then it's just a matter of going to Job Research, which you've done a few times now and should be familiar with. Mm-hmm. And then going across to Doja Hut. Let's call it Doja Hut.
We just came out of the market. I think that was the first time I ever came out of the market instead of
the market. The market is supposed to be the mid-tier location.
The Doja Hut for middle-level
characters, and technically that's kind of where we are now.
The Doja Hut. Kentucky Fried Chicken and a Doja Hut.
I want Pizza Hut. God damn it.
All right, and this is actually the first doja I've actually had on this tune.
Yeah, same.
Second.
And that takes me to 90. Hello, perks.
Hello, boobs.
I'm gonna have to do a lot of of alien XP grinding. Ah, boy.
Whee!
Woohoo! That is level 90 for me as well.
Status 89.
Whew! I should really...
Bye.
Should really go and sell all of the crap that I just picked up. Put all
I gotta
the boss
sell some pearls and some shiny gems.
So much
I've
stuff.
I've got a bag,
so
some crafting items.
Alright, are we going together?
Don't sell the perennium bolts, because those are actually good for trade skill.
All right. The perennium plate I'm begging.
Where are we gathering for sign off?
Just outside the hut?
That's fine.
It's outside the hut. Woohoo!
Yep.
Alright, everyone, that's going to be our live stream for tonight. Thank you for joining us. This has been Aaron Romeo Moon Burke here with Mad Matt Winchell.
I'm better.
Randy Ranson McCulloch.
Mission achieved.
And Krister. And then also joining us on our team was also Whisper Cat as well. So thank you for joining us, Whisper Cat.
Just came out.
She is a shade.
Who and, has a shade who ended this at 104.
GG.
We will be there probably in a few days. We're going to stop a bit and try to figure out where we're going to go next. We'll figure that out off the stream and let you guys know. We have a few ideas. It's just a matter of choosing which one we're going to do.
I think actually we are not going to be able to join come on tomorrow, is that right?
Nope, tomorrow we will be, I will be working 12 to 10 p.m., so I will not be on or able to stream. Wednesday
and
we will be on.
And then Wednesday's our usual podcast.
By usual podcast, I mean an unearthly podcast, also on Twitch, if you ever want to tune in for that. It's a Doctor Who themed podcast. This week we will be talking about World's End with Christopher Eccleston.
The End of the World.
The End of the World. Okay. The End of the
World's
World with Christopher Eccleston as the Ninth Doctor. So you can join us on Twitch for that on an Unearthly podcast.
Just basically a bunch of idiots getting up, just getting together and talking about one of their favorite TV shows.
Mm-hmm. And talking about the local news that surrounds it beforehand.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be a bad week, because we haven't done it in a couple weeks, so we've got some deaths to talk about.
Scheiße. Great. Please. No, that's right. Even non-Doctor Who deaths, we're going to talk about a couple of them.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. All right, everyone.
Yeah.
Have a good night. Thanks for joining us.
Good night, everybody.
Good night, everyone.